get her started.
Good morning. God bless you on this rainy Independence Day. Yes, there'll be fireworks tonight. They'll be wet, but at least nothing will burn up, probably.
That's true.
I probably should tell my story about the year I had bottle rockets. Almost took the head off my neighbor.
Oh, they had those on the news.
Yes, you gotta be careful with those.
A couple days ago, they had on the news. There was a truck had a whole mess of fireworks on it. They went off and blew up. And the guy that had them, they got to his house and they arrested them.
Okay. Be careful with your fireworks,
indeed.
Peggy, are you gonna come up and play the piano?
Right this minute.
Yeah, because we're gonna get right started with Happy Birthday, America. Happy birthday, Gerald. Who else? We're saying JoJo White's birthday is coming up in a day or two.
Tomorrow, yeah.
Yeah. Other birthdays, anniversaries?
I'm going up that stairs alone, girl. I'll tell you.
I'm good thing. How far she's coming along.
Yeah,
she does really well, but I don't trust them.
She wants to use the keg now.
Good, a little extra. My woman is pretty good too.
I remember it was a walker.
No,
it's a
keg.
That's good.
Yep.
You better go check in with your mom and brother.
She does. I know. I
Jesus.
I see Alistair back there filling out the refreshment sheet. Welcome back, Stella and Alistair. A long trip. But if you'd like to sign up, they're bringing some goodies, some donuts, some ho-hos, some ding-dongs. Some snack food for our Sunday mornings. It's so good to be back in the clubhouse. Why don't we sing Happy Birthday to all those celebrating birthdays? JoJo, Gerald, who else?
For the month or for the week?
Yeah, let's see, for the month of July.
Oh,
the end of July.
Happy birthday.
America's got a birthday.
And to our United States of America. Let's sing Happy Birthday.
Okay.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you. Amen. Let's sing a couple of our tunes that we have in the songbook. Good chance for you to open up your lungs, air them out. Where is America and songs that we have? That are and their numbers. Well, let's just look for America, and then we'll be right in the
62.
Thank you for finding that. Page 62. America the Beautiful. Good morning, Mary. We'll be on Facebook, recorded, eventually YouTube, and then shared it to Facebook. So people watching at home, we're thinking of you. Purple mountains, majesty above the right next door there on page 63 is My Country, Tis of Thee.
Oh, yeah, that's not good.
Oh, sweet land of liberty. Gracious God, thanks for this morning, a chance to celebrate our nation and nations around the world that live in freedom with justice and liberty for all. Be with us as we celebrate the birthdays in this congregation, and thank you for the gift of life, and thank you for the gift of love, that you love each one of us, and we celebrate that today with our communion. And it's in your name we gather and pray, and all God's people say,
Amen.
Amen. Who all gathered today? Cindy?
Clark Perry.
Praise God.
Helen Stuboy Hill.
Hello.
Hello. Stella Boy Hill.
Here.
John Atwell.
Here.
Peggy Shane.
Here.
Darrell Waterman.
Right here.
Judy Waterman.
Here.
Sandra Ferry.
God bless.
Joe Ferry.
Here.
Miguel Maldonado.
Here.
Joy Healy.
Here.
Len Heinick.
Here.
Ellen Heinick.
Here.
Gerald Dante.
Here.
Anna Palladino.
Here.
Mary Marshall.
Here.
Chuck Haight.
Here.
Carolyn Haight.
Here.
Jeff Dolan.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Peggy Martin.
Here.
Bob Lupinski.
Here.
Mary Sheldon.
Here.
Did I miss anyone?
Lucinda.
Oh, thank you. 23 today.
23. We sing number 21 every week. I see Peg's already got it turned in her book.
Excuse me, just one moment.
1 minute. Hang on, Peg. Hang on,
Peggy.
Peggy, it's me. I'm interrupting you. I'm sorry. I'm going to interrupt you. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay. This chart here is for signing up for the goodies at the back. And Sandra and Joe have been kind of looking after it. But I've got dates here that next week Stella and I are going to look after it. But there's dates here up until September the 5th. So I'm going to pass this around. You can pass it to your neighbor and see if we can get some signatures in here to do the goodies up until the 5th of September. Thank you.
Thank you, Alistair. I'm sure folks.
Because,
bring some goodies.
We need volunteers.
By the way, Cindy, I'm from Pennsylvania, so from now on when you make a roll call, you're going to hear me say, yo!
All right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Page 21.
Okay.
The trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time will be no more. The morning breaks eternal, bright and fair. Oh, and the saved on earth shall gather over on the other shore. And the roll is called of yonder, I'll be there. Oh, and the roll. Yonder. When the roll is calling yonder, I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, the glory of his resurrection share. When his chosen ones shall gather to their home, survivors of that awful building collapse over in Miami, and now with a tropical storm coming at least, and who knows what can happen as those storms get closer. We'll pray for that storm preparedness. We got some real flooding issues in our park, and I know you do too. Looking out the window, I can see the pond is right up as high as it gets, so there's no place to put the next water that comes in, and that's kind of what we're dealing with in our park. JoJo's home, and Cindy, what was the update?
She's having hip surgery. I think the date is July 26th.
So
she is in a lot of pain. She's really suffering.
So those of you that, along with me, know what that hip pain is like until you get that hip replaced. Keep JoJo in your prayers.
I have a friend just diagnosed with breast cancer, and she's already has it plateful, and this is a just added. Her name is Grace. I appreciate you mentioning her in your prayers. I want to remember the Holly family who passed away last couple weeks ago. So all people suffering and struggling with grief. Safe travel nurseries. Our friend was rear-ended on her way home. And she's okay, but be safe out there traveling. Praise God for our beautiful country, America. I praise God also that all of my sisters have all been having some issues over the past couple of years. All of my sisters are showing signs of improvement, and I praise God for that. Anyone else? Anna, I'll start here.
Karen. What's Karen's last name, Peggy? What's Karen's last name?
Karen Jurek.
Karen Jurek. Okay. Other prayers, yeah, Joe.
I have a CAT scan done tomorrow on my leg. I'm having problems with it, some rock pain. And I like also pray for our military, the guys that are coming back from Iraq.
Yep.
Pray for their families, because they're going to need it.
Yes.
Yep. From Afghanistan, Iraq.
They're out of there.
Thank you, Joe.
Judy.
What'd you say happened to the Hollies?
Robin Holly passed away.
A couple weeks. Yeah. Been a couple weeks now.
Bonnie's
husband. Anyone else?
Yes.
I had a couple praises. My cousin's mother went through open heart surgery on Friday for a bypass, and a new bell came through it fine. And a very good friend of my grandson's open heart surgery and came through that fine, but thought he was tough, didn't want to take the medicine, so he wasn't breathing deep enough. So now we're praying for pneumonia, but they both came through the heart surgery with no problems.
Carolyn, it's good to have some praises, isn't it? That's great. And even as we come out of this COVID, you know, be aware. Be careful. I came down with something. But I zeroed it in since last week, and I went, did I get that at church because we were holding hands? And I don't think so. I got it at the YMCA because it turns out there's a whole bunch of folks. The YMCA got this same kind of, you can hear it, stuffed up sinus. So be careful because the COVID's still around. And we're certainly still going to have the flu and colds. Things around, so.
So when you circle the room today, don't hold hands or make sure you wash your hands as soon as you get home.
So we pray for all of that. Hungry and the homeless, they're certainly there. We our beach ministry still goes along. It takes different shapes over the years. We're delivering lots of sandwich bags and stuff on Thursdays, and. Just all of the people that provide food are all away. They're traveling. So Cindy and I have had to do the things that we've got other people that usually do. So we go to Metropolitan Ministries on Thursday, pick up 100 sandwiches, and we go up to the beach and serve the just 30 or 40 that we feed there. But then there's a couple destinations where we go out into some wooded areas and drop off a crate of sandwiches. Isn't this weird? They're strange. The way you do it, you put the sandwiches down near the edge of the woods, you beep your horn, it's like a code. You beep your horn 3 times, and they come out of the woods to get their sandwiches.
That's great. It just gives you an appreciation for what other folks that are helping us, that what they do.
Yes, we really, and I would add that to our prayers. We're thankful for our real ministry partners. I mean, Cindy and I have the easy part. We usually just get there on Thursdays, say prayers and play some music, but it's hard work that gets done by the.
They're really the foot soldiers.
Yeah, they're the foot soldiers. They really work hard delivering the food.
And even when they go away, they're still doing that wherever they go. They're not, you know, they don't go on vacation. They wherever they go, they're still doing this.
Yeah, they're up.
Kind of ministry, but they're up in Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania, the Panhandle. Yeah, wherever they go.
Be careful, the animals do not go after the food.
That's true. Yeah. Gerald, because the places where we drop off the food, if these homeless folk aren't careful, they'll be evicted because there is a lot of trash shopping carts. And yeah, they've got a...
It's kind of sketchy.
It's sketchy. Other prayers today? Yeah, Jeff?
Praise the Lord, I found a job this week.
Awesome. Praise God, found a job.
Thank you for your prayers.
And thank you for helping Don set up.
We'll be, my pleasure.
Appreciate that. Sunday mornings. Anna?
Keep praying for my son.
Anna's son, keep him in your prayers. Never forgotten. I know always on your heart, Anna. We know you do. Well, let's pray. Gracious God, thanks for this morning. A chance to pause. We thank you that you make us people of prayer. We don't understand it, but we know that you've told us whatever's on our heart, lay it before you, and you've got this. We don't. We are not in control. Thank you, Lord, for those moments where you give us that gift where we can see that we might be your helper. But Lord, give us strength to keep helping those people we've mentioned here today. We're thankful for the blessings, people that have been on the mend for successful heart surgeries. We anticipate success for JoJo's hip and for all those who are doctoring for things that Joe's MRI will show something that the doctors can help him with. Lord, thank you for all of these things. For our adult children, Lord, we pray for them. We pray that you would guide their families through the situations that face them. We're thankful for all those that have been mentioned here today in our prayers, because we know that by mentioning them, we acknowledge that you know, that we know, that you know this is going to turn out all right. Lord, thank you for a nation in which to live where we have our amount of freedom. Lord, be with those nations who still struggle for liberty and for justice, for all people. This morning as we pray, remind us how blessed we are to live in a nation like this. We're thankful for soldiers that returned home, those men and women who have served in Afghanistan, in Iraq, and all over the world, and those that still have places in places like South Korea and all those places where we're on the border of places that don't enjoy the freedoms we have. Be with those men and women and remind them that you love them and care for them, not going to let them go, and that we can offer up our prayers. Lord, thanks for those that minister to the hungry and the homeless. Give them strength to just put one foot in front of the other and do what we can. And in the end, acknowledge that you love them and care for them and have a plan, and you won't let them go. Lord, be with Cindy today as she opens our hearts to your word from the scriptures, from your love letter to us. Thank you, Lord, for the word, for the Bible, for the scriptures. Come, Holy Spirit, be with Cindy as she opens our hearts. And thank you for the musicians that lead us in worship. Thank you for Peg, that she's been on the mend and can be at that keyboard that she loves so much, and play the piano and lead us in music and in worship. And Lord, so many other things that we offer up in our silent prayers. Look deep into our hearts. Hear our prayers, O Lord. These and all our prayers we offer up in the strong and powerful name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, who taught us all to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. You got one for us, Peg? What would you like us to sing?
Oh, how about 42?
How about 42? Let's stand up and sing it. Stretch your legs, y'all. Stretch out your lungs, stretch out your legs. Stand up if you're able. Move around a little bit. Oh, come on, Gerald. You're just a kid.
To my heart, pardon, an empty grave.
do before Peg leaves the platform?
44.
That's a favorite. If I'm not mistaken, that's going to be the mansion. Okay, Daryl, we got our part. Remember for Charlie. That one's for Charlie.
Yeah, that's Charlie.
I said those whispering sweet nothings in our music.
You'll never know.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's pray. Gracious God, thank you for today. Father, we give you all the glory. We are so grateful to be here. We praise and glorify your name. Help us to be inspired and lift us closer and closer to you. Be with me now, this moment, that I speak only the truth. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Anybody ever see those Reminisce magazines?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Well, a long time ago, I thought they were so quaint. But now, when I look at one, I see, like, the Beatles, things in there from my childhood. I don't know if they're so quaint anymore. But I do like to reminisce, don't we? Don't you like to reminisce and think about? I like to think about the things that make me feel happy. And one of the places that I like to return to in my mind is the little Bible house in Rushford, New York. It was across the street from the school. So we got to put on our coats in the wintertime and our boots, and we trudged across the street in the snow over to the Bible house in the summertime, go over there, and the they had these wooden benches, just a one long, simple wooden bench. My feet didn't touch the floor. My feet still don't touch the floor. But I would sit on a bench, swing my feet. I still swing my feet. And look out the window. The windows were always dusty. But the sun would be streaming in, and it's kind of beautiful in a way. It's a happy memory for me, sitting in that little Bible house with the sun streaming in. You could see the dust in the sunbeams and the swinging my feet. And our teacher, Mrs. Butterfin, and I thought that was kind of a funny name at the time, Butterfin, Mrs. Butterfin. And I thought she was really old, but she probably wasn't really all that old at that time, but she was short and round and gray hair and glasses, and she had a beautiful smile. She would teach us scriptures, and we'd sing songs. And you might not know this, you might not believe this, or believe it or not, but I had a hard time paying attention. So my little brain is always, it's here for a moment, but then it's over there. It's over there, it's over there, tonight. It's just this way I am. But we learned in that little Bible house the scripture, John 3:16. Who doesn't know that verse? For God so loved the world, he gave his only son to die. Yes, that's it. Well, this is what we learned. For God so loved the world, he gave his only son, you know it, to die on Calvary's tree. From sin set me free. Someday he's coming back. What glory that will be. Wonderful his love for me. I learned that song all the while swinging my feet and looking out the dusty window. Yes, we learned that song in Sunday school. For God so loved the world, that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Well, here's another important verse. John 3:17. Like millions of kids, I learned and memorized John 3:16, but it took me a long time to understand the magnitude and how important it was. In fact, it wasn't until I became an adult and until I totally tried to destroy my life, and I got rescued like a feral cat. I got rescued. And it wasn't until then that I began to understand the importance of John 3:16. But then later on, in my early, I'm kind of elderly now, so somewhere in my younger middle age life, let's say, I discovered John 3:17. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Oh, really? How did I miss that? How did I miss that? Because I think that verse is as important as John 3:16. Do you know how it hit me? It hit me because I started reading my Bible. No, now when I got the epiphany about reading the 3 pages a day, I could get through the Bible in a year. Not then. But I reached a bad place in time, and I was in a difficult place in my life. I didn't get it as a kid. I got it as an adult, when I got rescued like the cat. The importance that God did not come to condemn the world, but to save it. I think that's important for people to know. I think when I was a child, let me see how I can phrase this. I didn't understand the concept that we are forgiven. And I didn't understand the concept that being forgiven, and accepting Jesus that I wasn't going to mess up again. Because we do. I do, daily. I cannot get through a day without saying or doing or thinking something that I sure wish I hadn't said or done or thought. It's just my nature, my human nature. We went to a life group one night, and a small group of us, a couple pastors there, a couple folk, other folks, and there was one person. And we went around the group, you know, we talked about things. And this one girl, I wish I was her. She said, "I've never done anything wrong."
Wow.
Boy, I said, "Boy, sister, I want to be you. I want to be you." And the more I thought about that, and I thought about her, and I think about her every now and then, and I think, I wonder if you've never, or you think you've never done anything wrong, how much compassion do you have for people that have done wrong? And maybe that's where the sin, she might not realize she has, maybe. I don't know, because, you know, I didn't get to know her that well. I only know that she's never done anything wrong. I don't know the rest of the story. But I think about that every now and then. Boy, I love to be her. It's not going to happen. So, you know, I have a hard time paying attention. And Clark will say to me, "You know, come on over here and sit down. Just sit down." So I go over and I sit down. But inside my shoes, my feet are running. He can't see it, but he sees my shoes. My shoes are vibrating. It's hard for me to sit still. Every single day, he gets up, and I had this already written down this morning, so I was checking to make sure I had it right. Every single day, 7 days a week, he gets up, makes his coffee, and he sits down with his devotionals and his journal, and for about an hour, he seeks God every single day. And I really admire that quality. My feet are moving now, just thinking about it.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah. I really admire that quality, and I want to do that. But maybe I have to do my devotionals on the run. No, I don't know. We all have our own way of seeking God. Our work in our ministry is mostly seniors. Here at Atria and even in our beach ministry, there's seniors. Even our homeless people are seniors. Many of them are homeless. Homeless veterans and just ladies, they're seniors. And some of our people in our congregations are in their hundreds. Some are only in their 90s. And they will ask me, "Why am I still here?" My little Clarice, she's 108, and she would say to me, "Why am I still here?" I say, "Clarice, you still have things to teach me." And we still can use that time to worship God, to be an example, to teach others, to encourage others. And I have so much to learn. Amen.
The table that's set before us isn't a table set by the Cloverleaf Christian Fellowship or by a Presbyterian church or a Catholic church or a Lutheran church. or you name your church, it's a table set by our Lord Jesus Christ, who we get to know in the scriptures and in the word, like when it's brought forward by Cindy today, where she, by the Holy Spirit, tells us what she feels about the scriptures. And so today, when we come to this table, remember, it's a table set by our Lord and our Savior. On the night that Jesus was betrayed, after giving thanks, he took bread and he broke it. And he said to his disciples, "This is my body and it's given for you." In the same way, after he'd finished the meal, he took the cup and he poured it full. He said, "This is a covenant, it's a promise shed in my blood. It's for the forgiveness of the sins of the many, or the sins of the world." And he said, "Every time you eat this bread or drink this cup, do this in remembrance of me." Remembering all that he taught us, all that he showed us, all that he inspired us to. So take and eat and drink and remember Jesus. Here you go, Joy. Yeah, thank you.
I'd like to say something.
Yeah, Judy.
I was in the bridge group at a home, and they had this priest come in, and he was giving, you know, he was giving communion to everybody, and most of them were Catholic, but he wouldn't give it to me. He refused. Mm. And I've always remembered that and felt bad.
That happened to me too, Judy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, yes.
Yeah, we weren't in a church or anything.
It's hard, isn't it? You try to honor traditions. Cindy and I went to a wedding one time where the tradition was communion was to be taken by the couple and for the congregation. And it is pretty sad when they only invite the people that are part of that congregation. There's reasons for that. It's church polity. It's a particular church's polity. And it's hard when that happens. Yeah, that's a hard one. So depend. Let's see. There's. You know what? I'm not going to use that one. There's some of you have somebody at home. I don't know if you took it, another one to take home. But there's a couple more up here. After they finish the meal, so take your piece of bread and take and eat. Do this in remembrance of him. And then take and drink. Peel open that. There's all kinds of imagery that goes with these little COVID communion cups that became so popular. But opening those seals is like the opening of the grave in which Jesus was sealed. And we open the grave, and out from the grave he arose, a mighty victory o'er his foes. Yeah, the victor from the dark domain. Yeah.
Frank and Diane.
Frank and Diane, yep. There's a couple more up here. Maybe
some,
yeah, there's more. If you need to take some communion home to the family. Finished the meal, Jesus prayed, and then they sang a hymn. So let's pray. Gracious God, thanks for this time to share your body and your blood and to be reminded of all you did for us on the cross. Whether our sins are few, like the woman that Cindy met at a Bible study, or our sins are many, that's what your words remind us, that we are forgiven. And this is a meal that reminds us that. Amen. Let's stand and sing.
Get up anyway.
Blessed be the tie that binds our hearts in Christian love, the fellowship of kindred minds is like to that above.
Luke 2:14 says, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." May God bless you today. Go and love and serve the Lord. And all God's people said,
Amen.
Hey, say hello to like Doris Cameron and all those folks at home, Elaine, and that away. Kind of an anonymous wave. There you are. See you in the future, or see you in the pasture. Say goodbye, Cindy.
Bye.
Oh, I left the camera.